Good evening. I hope you've all had a good day. It's been absolutely glorious out there. I know we've got a lot of people following us from all over the place, from Afghanistan, Cyprus, with people from America, Canada,
Thailand.
So hopefully it's just been as nice with you. But here today, it's been lovely. We've not been able to go very far. The garden has been about the limit. However, it's been good to get a little bit of vitamin D. So we're back indoors now to do a little bit of cooking. Tonight we've got a nice easy salmon dish, creamed leeks. I'm going to do some mushrooms, not for me. So normally it's Brody that's the fussy one, however I can't stand these little things. And then some asparagus. Okay, so using up a little bit of that cream that we used last night into our mashed potato. We've got a little bit of garlic, a little bit of ginger. First thing we're going to do is get some oil into that pan. And we're going to season the salmon and get the salmon on, all right? So let's get that going first. I'm feeling in a kind of nice, happy mood this evening, so I'm going to put a little bit of music on. I'm happy for you to put some requests through as we go. I'm going to start with, Alexa, play Here Comes the Sun.
This Here Comes the Sun by the Beatles.
Good, so it's got to be summer related, it's got to be happy, it's got to be nice. Right, oil's on in the pan. Let's get this salmon over here. So, I've got the salmon skin on, so I'm going to put it skin side down. I could use my filleting knife, remember we did the other day when we bent the knife around and took that skin off. However, I'm just going to go skin on, and I'll just take the kids off, the kids' skin off there in a minute because they don't like it. Right, salt and pepper. So, I'm just going to do the top two. Okay, so it should be really nice, quick, easy dish tonight. I'm going to turn it over, so that will sit now. Flesh to flesh. A little bit of salt and pepper on the skin side down. I've gone with an 8 on the temperature, so we've got like a medium high heat. Is the stuff going to be? Yes, it is. Cool. Right, so let's just move that around. Let's get that oil moved around and then we can pop that skin side down. As soon as that goes in.
Your brother's tuning in.
I know. I've told him to tune in. Because it's his birthday. And I would like to say happy birthday to Jordan, Connor Birchall, 19 years old today. And if he would like to request the song, as long as it's nothing, then I will put it on. If it's rubbish, it won't go on, even though it's your birthday. I hope you enjoyed your card and your couple of bits that we sent you down the other day. Let's say happy birthday. In fact, here we go. I'm sure you've already opened one up, Jordan. I don't drink every night, but this is my brother's birthday. Happy birthday, mate.
Lies.
Okay, there's one to you. Right, that, let's go a little bit hotter. I want a bit more heat coming out of that. But when that skin goes down, I want it to be sizzling quite nice and warm. As soon as that goes in, all right, we're going to start preparing our leeks. Okay, then we'll get the leeks prepared, we'll get the onion, we'll get the garlic and the ginger prepared, and we'll start getting that going into this pan. Okay, and then we'll start getting our mushrooms going. The last thing we'll do is our asparagus. So that's the order it'll go in, okay? Cool, let's have a little look there. Yeah. So skin side down, salmon going in. So I'm just going to turn that around now. It's already got a little bit of seasoning on it because we just turned that on its head just a second ago. So I'm just going to do the other side of the skin. So you can more than welcome to remove it if you want to remove it. Use a nice filleting knife like we demonstrated the other day. We can do it again next week if you missed it. Okay, so skin side down on all four pieces of salmon. There we go, let's get rid of that. Let's give your hands a quick wash. Okay, what we're going to do with the leeks then? A nice sharp knife. I'm going to take the brown, kind of not so good looking stuff off the top. Right, now, really important that we wash these. Now, if you just have a quick look, all that kind of crap in there, all right, there's nothing wrong with it. Okay, it just needs washing. It's come from the ground, it's brought some mud with it. Don't worry about it. What we're going to do, I'm saying don't worry about it because the camera lady just made a right face. Got mud. Yeah, no shit. It came from the ground. Okay, so I'm going to go halfway down through it. Okay, and actually, you see, it's only got the mud in the top little bit there. So what I'll do is I'll take that off. Okay, we'll get rid of that. That's where all our mud and that sat there. Okay. And then, I'll just give them to rinse through. I use the outer, I'm going to lose the outer leaves. A couple of the outer leaves gone. Come on in, music request. Here comes the sun's finish. Okay, I'm going to run the water through that.
Paul Gerry wants to know if you're turning into Keith Floyd.
Paul Gerry, Keith Floyd, yeah. Thank you. So he used to drink red wine, didn't he? Paul Gerry, here's a question for you. 1892 is the year that this T-shirt, Abercrombie & Fitch, the company, was formed. What other great institution was formed in 1892? Okay, what am I going to do now then, guys? Use my finger, using the knife, my nail. Okay, nice, thin. Push that half over to one side. Okay, and again, just using my nail, guys, to roughly gauge about a couple of mil. Yeah, so I'm just moving that finger back. I'm keeping the tip of the knife down, and I'm just running the heel of the knife through, so the knife's doing the work.
You've got three people answered that question.
Go on.
Paul Gerry.
Yeah.
Jordan Birchall. Yeah. And Spencer Wilson. All got it right.
All got it right, okay. There was also a watch company in America that made the first digital watch in 1892. American watch company. What company was it? Okay. Leeks. One done. Do you know what I'm going to... I said two. These are quite big leeks, guys, so I'm only going to go for 1.5 for my lot. So down in half again. That's half a leek. That one, I'm going to give it a rinse anyway, but it actually is a lot cleaner than its brother. Like me and my brother Jordan, I was the clean leek. Okay. Okay, using the finger. Beautiful, just snip it through. So keeping the tip of the knife down, guys, is all I'm doing. Okay, just using the heel of the knife, making the knife do the work. I know exactly what Jordan and Paul Gerry and Spencer are all thinking. I would love him to slip now and cut his finger.
Evening, Coochie.
Evening, Coochie. Coochie just missed the quiz.
And Paul Gerry says Hamilton.
Hamilton, great shout, mate. Well done. Very good. He's just been on Google. Right. Oh, I missed one. Okay, salmon's cooking away nicely. Let's get some butter. So a little bit of that butter left over from last night. I'm going to use the slightly bigger bit. So about a tablespoon of butter there, guys. I'm going to turn this salmon down a little bit because it's cooking away quite nicely there. And I don't want it to cook too quick, so I want obviously it all to come together at the same time. So I'm going to get my butter going. Got to get that one in an 8. Okay, so we've got our leeks already. Probably got more leeks there that I need, but it doesn't really matter. Excuse me, it's my nose got having a right little itch attack.
You missed the quiz, Coochie.
Quiz.
He's saying what quiz?
The quiz. What else was formulated in 1892, mate? What other great institution? Okay, I'm just going to take the rubbish part off my garlic. I've got a little bit of brown on there.
Chris Agnew says Ingersoll. That was what he thought the watch was.
Ingersoll, could well be. I don't know, I'll have a little look. The one I was thinking of was Hamilton. Okay guys, so I just pop the skin on the garlic. I'm just running my knife really nice and thin through that garlic. So if you have a quick look there, camera lady come in nice and, yeah, some nice thin little bits. Then all I'm gonna do there is down through it again. Nice and small. Okay, so my butter, have a quick look at my butter. You don't need to move it, just have a quick look at it.
You're so bossy.
Oh, I am bossy. You don't need to get involved. Just hold that camera and do your job, woman. Okay, just chopping through that garlic. I'm going to go with just one of those for the minute because the other one is going to be for the mushrooms. All right, however, my ginger, I'm going to keep the skin on the ginger. We don't need to mince around with it. Okay, I'm going to turn that down a touch. It's starting just to bubble away. Ginger, skin on, you would never know. Nice, small, slivers again. Okay, now just going through that. And I'm going to do exactly the same with the ginger as just what I just did with the garlic. So just cue it up, give it some sort of order. Take nice little small pieces. So if you find you can see any big pieces in it, obviously just chop them in half. And that's going to make the base of the flavour for this creamed leeks. So really low carbohydrate meal tonight. A little bit more in fats. We've used butter, we've used cream, so a little bit of a kind of keto dish if you're into that kind of stuff. Right, garlic and ginger in first. So sweat that off. Right, I literally want to cook it just until I can start smelling that. The fragrance coming from both of those. That's all I want to do. Okay, so have a quick look in there, look. I'm going to move that around. It's not going to take long at all. In fact, you say when you can smell that. Okay, I'm going to turn my fish. So I have that skin side down. Maybe not quite enough. Oil in there for that skin, but hey ho, all right, kids want it off anyway. Okay, now what I'm going to do next then, so I'm going to get a little bit of sweet chili sauce in on top of that. Okay, that will help it stick in there anymore anyway. So sweet chili
that
sauce,
smells lovely.
There we go, smells out. So that's when, as soon as you can smell it, that is when those leeks go in. All right, guys. And then I'm just going to get those leeks absorbing. So I just went off on one now. We're back to add our sweet chili sauce, but we've just gone in with that, with those leeks. Right, now you want to make sure they're coated in butter right away. So we're just moving those leeks around. Right, they'll start breaking down in there, just like onion. Yeah, they'll just start breaking down, just like onion. Now I'm just going to go over drizzle over the top. But this will caramelise, this will get hot and it will kind of get quite sticky. Might even turn into like a dark kind of brown colour. Not a problem, it'll just be quite sweet and quite nice. There you go, don't be shy with it. I've gone with about, what, half a bottle there. And the bottle is 380 grams. There we go, let's put that to one side. Okay. That, I feel like I've got enough leeks there, guys. My leeks were really big, so I know I said two in the recipe, but if you've got humongous leeks, maybe just reduce it down. I went for 1.5, and I still feel like I've got quite a bit left over. I hate wasting things, so it's gonna go in. Normally, I'll just pop that to one side, but don't like to waste. Okay, let's give that one a quick wipe down. Let's have a quick recap. Don't necessarily need to wipe it down, because I've not been using any raw meat or fish on it. Just as a quick tidy up, and now let's get mushrooms going. I'm not a big fan, however, the rest of the family are. So I'm going to go into quarters. Again, I know in the recipe I said halves, however, look at the size of my mushrooms, they are giant arthropod. Okay, so we're going to go for quarters of those. I'm going to use that other little knob of butter, and that's going to go into the other pan. Let's get that warmed up. Okay, I'm going to turn it up to a 10, that will be sizzling away in no time. If you get any sort of long mass, I'm not going to take all the short stalks off, but if you get anything really long, just get rid of it. Okay, and then into quarters. That one's not too big.
Ruth says, looking good. Vicky Floyd.
Yes, hello, Vicky, how are you?
Awesome DB. And Christian says he's got a song for you, Dean. What is it then, mate?
Let's go get it going then, because Jordan never came back with one, did he? I'm playing my birthday song and everything.
Great Balls of Fire by Jerry Lewis.
Alexa, play Great Balls of Fire by Jerry Lewis. Great song. Who knows the film? Everyone knows the film, of course, surely. And you rattle my brain. I'm going to go a little bit more oil there, guys. Those mushrooms, that's all the butter I had left. Those mushrooms will absorb that. They're very, they're like sponges. So let's go suck all that butter and all that oil up. Okay, mushrooms are ready to go.
Top Gun. Ruth Marie Rogers.
She was fast on the ball. Right, we're going to use the heel of the knife, pop the garlic, take the little rooty bit off the end, and there you go, the skin has magically disappeared. We're going to use that other piece of garlic, so two cloves of garlic on the recipe. We're going to use them both. One's gone into the leeks, which I want to give a little stir. And then, so they're just starting to get kind of shiny and glassy now. So that won't be long before the cream goes into those. I'm going to turn that one down because it's not got anything going on it and it's making some noise saying, where are you, what are you doing? I need some food in me. So mushrooms are going to go in. Oh, I almost had to go a whole clove of garlic there. Mushrooms are in. Lovely. Okay, let's just get that clove of garlic chopped up nice and small again. Alexa, volume up.
I reckon Ruth could challenge you to a movie quiz.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Bring it on, Ruth. Garlic in the mushrooms. Drive me crazy. Goodness gracious, just great balls of fat. Take me to bed and loose me forever, goose. Come on then, Ruth, give us a song. Okay, let's have a look at those leeks. So have a quick look into those leeks, guys. Have a look into those leeks. Okay, so they've gone nice and soft. Yeah, they're really starting to kind of wilt down a little bit, and that's when we'll start getting that little bit of creaming in a minute, all right? Okay, let's move those mushrooms around. We don't want those sticking. We want to make sure they're all coated again in oil. Come on in, it's quiet here. Give me another song request.
I've got a message from Paris, but I'm not sure, I don't understand it. Jerry Cinnamon, Where We're Going. Jordan reckons you might actually like this one.
Jerry Cinnamon, Where Are We Going?
Where We're Going.
Alexa, play Where We're Going. Splash of cream. Big splash of cream. There you go. Let's have a look. Okay. Big splash of cream went into those there, guys. Yeah, I'm going to use a little bit more. I want a nice bit of cream in this dish. It's really important though, guys, to point out that I should turn that heat down that little bit more. I don't want my cream splitting. All right, too hot and it's just going to go, nah, don't like it. All right, let's use a different spatula, please. Okay, maybe my mushrooms a little bit too dry. All right, they want a little bit more moisture. Like I said, they absorb really, really quickly, all right? So I know I added three different types of oil in there, however, it doesn't matter, all right? Because I'm going to use down just a touch of olive oil just to keep them drying out at the bottom. That's all I'm doing. But you do have to use more oil than usual when you use your mixed up mushrooms, because they just suck it up. Right, so let's recap. Mushrooms are on the go. Garlic's in with them. I'm going to turn that heat down a little bit. Let's have a look in here. Our cream leeks are going nicely. I've put two big glugs of cream into that with ginger and garlic. Okay, our salmon's just cooking away here nicely with a nice bit of Thai sweet chilli. So 5 minutes and we are done. The last thing that's going to happen, I'm going to get my steamer on, asparagus to finish off the dish. Right, so what will happen in a minute then, we'll place a nice bed of cream leeks on the bottom. We will dot some mushrooms around the outside, salmon on top, asparagus laid over the top of that. So remember what I said to you the other day, when you've been using asparagus, the woody stalks will just break naturally off. There's not much of a woody stalk on these, I can already tell. Right, so that's going to be a very short little, there we go. That's it, that's all that's coming off, that's all your waste. Steamer on. I've gone with 5 stalks each. 5 stalks, leeks and mushrooms, so plenty of goodness. Like I said, a little bit higher in fat, but low in carbohydrates. So take the rough and smooth.
Walk like an Egyptian. Nathan Yardley.
Who's asked for that?
Nathan Yardley.
Who?
And
well, it hasn't been requested, but I did say I was
going to go. If you liked it.
No, I just said if it wasn't. It's not. Right. Okay, let's get rid of a bit of rubbish. Cream gone. That one gone. Mushrooms finished with. Okay, so all we're looking for is the steam to be stopped popping out of that. That steamer. I'm going to go with a little bit of, I know with salt and pepper with the salmon, I'm going to go with a little bit of pepper into my leeks. Oh yeah, they're good. They're good. You see what I mean by not going for the two though? One and a half was plenty there today. Nice. Mushrooms, keep moving them around. Okay, I'm going to turn those mushrooms down because they're not far off it. I don't want to overcook them, I don't want them looking like greasy spoon mushrooms. Okay, so literally like I said, we're waiting for that water just to come up. Asparagus going in. Salmon's all looking good. I'll whip the skin off the children's in a minute. We'll have the skin on. And that will be a job done. What were you looking at time? One of the fastest, I reckon. So we're going to have a rest tomorrow evening. It's fajita Friday in our house. Don't think anyone needs to know how to cook fajitas. And then we'll be back tomorrow morning for our HIIT session. And then we'll be back Saturday morning for our last adult session of the week, which will be dumbbell chest and back. And then Sunday, it's someone's birthday. And then Monday, we'll be back. Usual, I'll put a schedule up for those of you that just want to follow. Really, guys, if it's helping, if you're enjoying these kind of little cooking things, if you're enjoying the workouts, then that's all good with me, because I'm enjoying it too. And it gets me out of bed.
Whose birthday is it?
I don't know.
Someone's.
Someone's. Yeah. I don't know. Someone's. How old is she going to be?
Doesn't count.
Doesn't count.
No.
Oh, because of coronavirus, because of the COVID-19, this birthday.
Yeah, lockdown birthdays don't count.
Case, if it doesn't count, then can we just not worry about it? Okay, steamer's on. No comments. Lids off. Asparagus in. There we go. So we're looking at about asparagus. I was saying the other day about 5 minutes for our vegetables. Asparagus isn't very, very nice when it goes soggy. So we're going to call it 3 minutes tops, all right? So I'm talking 8:26, we're going to start plating up. So you've got 3 minutes to stick with us. Alexa, play Walk Like an Egyptian.
Thank you, Ruth.
Alexa,
happy birthday for Sunday.
Play Walk Like an Egyptian.
29, I wish. Julie Polglaze tuning in for the first time.
Julie Polglaze asking what?
Tuning in for the first time.
Tuning in for the first time.
She said it looks like a good one.
It was lovely to speak to you today, Julie. We had a little catch up. I was busy working on some of your bits after we had the chat today, so that's really cool. Okay. Two minutes, guys, and then we'll serve up. Okay, if you've got any of that chili sauce left over, quite nice just to drop that around the plate afterwards. However, there's going to be quite a lot in that pan there. Still 2 minutes. Any questions on this one, guys? I think leeks get overlooked quite a bit. They're actually really nice. They're really good with Thai flavours, leeks. So you could have done lemongrass. We could have had a little bit of that Thai fish sauce. You know that kind of those flavours we did with the mince dish the other night? really good in here and go really well with fish. Yeah, so that's very transferable. Any fuzzies? Put them on there now and I'll answer them in the next 1 minute. Okay, I'm going to just take that temperature up on everything just before I serve, just to make sure it's nice and quite a bit hot. Brody! Come and lay the table, please. Okay, about that time.
Ruth wants to know, where's your beer, Dean?
Where's my beer? Brody, I need a beer as well. Okay, so this bit, nice bed. Cream leeks in the middle. Okay. Then I'm going to go.
Say hello, bird.
Okay, piece of salmon on top. This will be for someone who likes mushrooms.
I like mushrooms.
You like mushrooms?
Yeah.
So not a huge meal tonight, guys, but then we haven't been doing a huge amount today. So it all reflects energy that we have burnt. Alright, so a nice little bit of mushroom. So I'm going to turn everything off the heat now because it doesn't need to cook anymore. Yeah, so our meals really reflect what we've been doing. If we've been doing lots, then we will be eating more kind of starchy carbohydrates. But if we haven't, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We won't.
Julie's just said, you've got kids that eat what you cook. Heaven.
Yeah.
It's either that or they don't get fed, Julie, I'm afraid.
Okay, so I'm just going to finish that with just that little bit around the outside. Beautiful. Mm. There we go. Salmon, creamed leeks, a little bit of garlic mushrooms. Finish with a bit of asparagus on top. Guys, hopefully join us in the morning. We've got a no-hit family hit session at 9:30. That will be it for the cooking this week. I like to have 3 nights off where I don't have to stand in front of the camera. Although I do enjoy it. I do enjoy it.
So do I.
So do you. yeah, it'll just get slopped together when I'm not on the camera. There you go. So yeah, hopefully see you tomorrow morning. Saturday morning we'll do a dumbbell chest and back session. You have got until 8 o'clock this evening to get your orders in if you want food delivered to your door. Our prep food service is now available. We will, so those orders need to go in before 8 this evening for your deliveries on Monday. All right, have a look at the DB Fitness and Nutrition website, or simply put in db.kitchen. That will take you to where you need to go. Have a little look, get some orders going. Cheers, guys. Have a good evening. Later.